Thanks so much, Michaela. Yeah, that's definitely something fun to do this weekend. Another thing fun to do this weekend, and the weather's going to be just like it is today, we're really enjoying it outside, is to perhaps sail away to Block Island. There's an event that's happening, and here with us today is Mark Broder, the Rhode Island director of tourism.
That's correct.
So tell us about this event that's happening on Block Island.
Well, what happens, this is the third year the event is happening, and the businesses on Block Island get together with the Chamber of Commerce, and they create an event on the island that really showcases all the great things the island has to offer, a little pre-season.
Yeah, and it's true, it's not just taste of Block Island for food, but a taste of everything.
It certainly is.
And what I think is awesome is that there's deals. How can we get these deals?
Well, certainly, you just purchase a $5 pin, and you can purchase that at the airport. The New England Airlines is offering a $59 round-trip rate, or at the ferry landing in Galilee, or just at the Chamber of Commerce once you arrive on the island.
And we brought some of the buttons here, too. So we can just pick that up. It's really simple to do that. And one of the deals that you just mentioned was that $59 deal from the airport to the Block Island Ferry, and apparently people do that.
Well, absolutely. It's one of the fun ways of getting over to the island and having a great view as you arrive.
I never thought to do that, and I love that. I'm going to look into it. Also, what are some other things that you can do and get deals once you purchase the button?
Well, the button is going to allow you to participate in entertainment events, certainly wine and tastings and beer tasting, discounts on all types of appetizers and desserts, make your own sundae, but also the actual events that you can rent mopeds and
get discounts and
wakeboarding all various types of activity to go out and enjoy the natural areas of the island as well as all the shops throughout the island.
Right, and I think that we're showing too some of the beautiful island, which is so important to explore. And another thing that that they're doing there on the island to help explore is finding glass balls by a company that's in Wakefield.
Yes, Evan Horton is a glass artist, and he's created 400 ornaments that can be either used on the lawn or on your Christmas tree, and they've been hidden throughout the island. And Friday, they're starting off the event, which will happen right through October.
How fun is that?
It's great. And I was out on the island yesterday, and the director of the Tourism Council said that they're putting helmets on with flashlights, going out during the night and hiding all of these ornaments throughout the island.
Oh, that's so great.
It's
fun. It's the real deal. And we know that there's so much food. There's a chowder festival, a cook-off going on Sunday.
On Sunday.
And everybody can actually vote for that. The beaches are always free. There's so much to do in Block Island. We were talking before, there's just a breath, and this is a chance to really see the island and to really appreciate it before all of the crowds and the tourists come. Even though it is special to come at that time, it's nice to see it now.
And there'll be hotel packages as well for those that wish to stay for the weekend.
Exactly. All right, Mark, thank you so much for being here to talk about
welcome.
This event.
Thanks for the opportunity.
And if you want to head to Block Island, you can get a link on all of this information on our website, WPRI.com. Just click on the Rhode Show.